Watching today. Today I am going to show you how to use our calendar templates in Photoshop. So when you first open your template, this is how it's going to look. In the layers panel, you're going to see that everything is currently turned on, meaning that this eyeball is showing, meaning it's showing it. And then this is going to be the thing you're seeing because it's on the top. This is just pointing out that you need to be aware that this whole artboard, which means this whole section, is including a bleed. So that means just design it all the way out to the edge and you'll be good. So this red box is the trim area. This is where they'll trim off your page so that it's 8.5 by 11. This is the size of your calendar. Next, you want to pay attention to this green line, which is called the safe area. And this is the area where it'll ensure that nothing gets cut off from your calendar. This also makes sure that you don't get anything in either one of these drill holes, so because if you do get text or anything up there, it will get punched out. Keep in mind that our templates are in CMYK, so if you're editing an image that's an RGB and imported in, there will be a slight color shift because it is converting it from RGB to CMYK, so just keep that in mind. For now, you're going to come over here and click this instructions only, and then down here there's this trash can. That's how you delete a layer, so we're going to go ahead and delete it. And then say yes. So now you can see that all of the layers are turned on. We're going to go ahead and click all these eyeballs to turn them all off. So this, now you see just the blank artboard. This dotted line, these dots everywhere means that it's a transparent layer, which means when it prints, the background will just be white. So don't worry if that's all dotted, that's not going to be how it prints. So each layer is named in here. So let's first turn on the front cover because that's going to be what we're going to want to do first. To add an image, you're going to go to File, Place Embedded. From there, you're going to find the image you want as your cover and place it. So it opens like this. If you leave it like this, it'll be white here and here. So to make it fit the artboard, you're going to hold down the shift bar on your keyboard, click the one corner, and drag it. By clicking shift, it ensures that everything sizes correctly and that it's not, that the dimensions aren't changing up. So now that it's open, let's move it to where we want it to be and then click enter. And now it'll be placed in there. So now you see everything you add in here, whether it be a rectangle, an image, a text box, will create its own layer. So that was the first layer, and now the image has its own layer. Next, let's say we want to add some text. In this bar over here, you'll see this T, and that's going to be the type tool. You're going to click and drag a box, and then let's go 2018 calendar. To resize it, just select the text, go up here, and let's make it this big. And then you can even come in here and change out the font and the color if you'd really want to, but I'm not going to change the color right now. I do want the font changed. Okay, so once you have that, to move this around, you're going to click this little four arrow tool, because now you can move it around. So say I want it right here, and it's good. So now you see that made another layer. You're going to go again, say you want to add your logo. File, Place Embedded. Grab an image of your logo and place it. Right now this is super huge, so I'm going to hold down the shift bar so it doesn't skew it in any way and make it smaller. And then let's drag it up here, say we want it there, and press enter. So now you have your front cover. The next step is going to be to select all these layers, and you can do so by clicking one and then holding shift while you click the others, and click this little folder down here so we can group them. So now you have the first group. You're going to double click in here and rename it front cover. Now you have your front cover. Putting them in groups is very important just so you have an organized file. And also because at the end we're going to save it as a different file so you can flatten everything. You want to have them in groups and have this one so you can go back in, say next year, and change the text if you'd like. So let's for now turn off this this layer and turn on the January image layer. From there, let's go to File, Place Embedded, and place your January image. Again, you'll need to resize it, so while holding down Shift, you're going to drag each side so that it fits. And then you'll want to drag your image wherever you like it and click enter. So now the image is on there. So you can add text if you'd like on top of it, and I'm not going to at this moment because I don't really need it. So from there, you don't want to do that because now I just put that photo in that. So let's go back over here. So these, you'll want to grab your January photo and the image and group it. Or if you have text or anything you add on top of it, grab all of them and group it and then go January image. So now you know that's the January image. Let's go ahead and turn the eyeball off on that one and turn on the January grid. We're using the one of our ads with ad space because we wanted to show you how to hide this ad space because we do get questions on that. Since the background is technically white, to cover that ad space, all you have to do is click this rectangle tool over here, click and drag over ad space, and you want to make sure this fill is white because now it'll just blend into the background and now you'll have a white, just in a blank white spot down here. So now you can place your ads or an image or anything you'd like down here. Say you want to add somebody's birthday to this grid. You're going to click the T over here, which is for the type tool. You're going to drag a box. And right now this font is super huge, so let's go down to 10. Say it's Anna's birthday. Let's put it, say it's on the 11th. So now you can add your own text throughout. We do have a website that lists all the fonts used on each template, so that link can be found in the description of this video. So you can go through and whatever template you picked, you can figure out what fonts were used on each so you can match these ones if you'd like. From there, say that's all I want to do with the January grid. I just want to add the birthday. I want to cover this. You'll, if you need to, and then you can add whatever ads you want down here. So next thing is you want to turn on all of these January grid. Let's move. So sometimes these get down, and if you want to move it up, all you have to do is click it and drag it up. So let's drag it under January, under the front cover, just to keep it in order. Now we're going to select these three that we used for the January grid, and down here this little button, it's going to group them. Double click it and rename it January grid or GERD. Okay, so now we're done with that. Turn that one on, turn on the February one, and then it's going to be the same exact steps. You're going to file, place embedded, place your image, resize it, add any text, group them. Then you're going to go on to the February one, add anything in here you'd like, cover up the ad space if you have that, add your ads, select all those layers in this, and group them, rename it what it's for. So now let's file, save as, and we're going to save this as, let's say, my project. So this is, when you're done, you want to make sure that you save a document that has all these grouped ones, and then when you're finished doing all these layers for your calendar, you're going to go, and having them in groups, you're going to go to File, Save As, and you can go My Project, for, or even Printing Center. Because this will let you know that this file, and then you want to make sure that this layers is clicked down here. So let's click save. So now the next step, since this one is going to be for Printing Center USA, your next step is going to be to merge all these layers. So because you want to have, like say you're doing a saddle stitch, you're going to want to have 28 merged layers. One for your front cover, all the inside pages, and your back cover. We do not design the back cover, so you want to make sure to do that as well. So your next step, let's turn, so say when you're finished grouping all of these, your last step is to save it for Printing Center. Make sure to do this because you'll want to go in and edit this later. Say next year you want to change it to 2019, you need to have your other file, the one with these groups. Because next, I'll show you, you're going to turn on the front cover, select it, right click, and click Merge Group. This turns that group into one image. Everything is flattened onto one image. So now you can't go in here and edit the text. So that is why we recommend you saving one with the groups and one for us like this. So let's turn that one off, turn this one on, select it, right click, merge group. Now it's all one image. Turn that off, turn it on, click the grid, right click, merge group. So now this is all one image. So you're going to, after having all these in groups, you're going to continue doing that on every single group you have made so that it makes one image. And in the end, you're just going to file save and just make sure you have 28 and make sure to name them so when we get your files, we know what you want us to do. From there, you can save it as a PDF or you can just submit your 28 merged layers in this Photoshop document to us and we'll take care of it. Don't forget the one number one thing we want to remind you is you want to have two different files, one where you can go back and edit anything, so don't merge them, and then one with everything merged for us. So that's pretty, then you're going to just, you wanted to save it and then you'll be good. So that is that, and I hope you got the hang of using our Photoshop templates. We don't forget to see in the comments for any of the fonts we used in any of them, and please give us a call at 1-800-995-1555 if you have any more questions. Thank you.